Please join me in welcoming the spirit of Scythe, Jack Shoemaker.
Are you excited? And I have given a lot of my time and a lot of my money and a lot of my years to Scythe. Not because it would make me more successful or Alvin more successful, but because I wanted you to have the same dream and opportunity that I had. To not only make a difference in my family's lives, but to make a difference in those lives of all of those people that I met in the United States and around the world. I want to ask you for one little simple thing while I'm up here, and then I'll quit. Will you accept my challenge to make a difference in the lives of others throughout the world? Yes, please say yes.
Well, there are a lot of people who've been instrumental in the success of Scythe, but there's one person without whom Scythe wouldn't exist today. We wouldn't be international, and without the hard work done by that person over a lot of years to build a good foundation, we wouldn't be able to go on without him. And that person is Jack Shoemaker. I still remember the first time I met Jack. Scythe had been struggling. The recession of 1981 was really hard on Scythe. The founder looked for somebody else to take over and move the organization from Texas. I raised my hand and said, I'll do it. So we had 18 universities involved with Scythe in 1982. 1983, we had 18 universities involved with Scythe. And then we grew to 22 universities involved with Scythe. Every quarter when the board met, the question was, should we throw in the towel? Should we quit, or can we make it to the next quarter? And we always decided, because of stalwarts like Bob Plaster and Bill C, to say, let's just keep trying, let's keep making this thing work. Bill C called me one day. He was the founding sponsor of Scythe when he was the CEO of Southwestern Life Insurance Company out of Dallas. He said, Alvin, have you ever heard of a company named Walmart and a guy named Sam Walton? And I said, I sure had. Now, in 1982, that really wasn't that silly of a question, because Walmart was still a regional retailer. And Sam Walton hadn't been made famous as America's richest person then. But it was a growing company, and Bill C. said, you know, they've asked me, Sam asked me to come and serve on his board of directors. And I'm going to do that, and was wondering at the next board meeting if it was okay if I talked to Sam about Scythe.
So Bill came to a board meeting once in Walmart, in their offices, and said to Sam Walton, you know, this is an organization that's got a really good idea and a great concept. He said, but it's going to fail unless someone like you steps in and helps it continue. And he met in time, not just money. And so Sam talked to him quite a while, and I guess I was standing there listening. And Mr. Walton said to Mr. C that I just can't do this right now. I've got too many other things that I'm doing. Actually, Mr. Walton already had been told that he had leukemia at that time. And so he just didn't want to take on any additional responsibility beyond Walmart. And then he turned to Mr. C and he said, besides, he said, that sounds more like Jack than it does me anyway. He said, I don't know if Jack would be interested, but if he is and he wants to take this on, I can promise you and him that I'll support him in that endeavor.
Bill called me a couple days later and said, you need to call Jack Shoemaker and get him involved. He and Sam have talked, and Jack's been willing to step up and be the person at Walmart to really help get involved with Scythe. So I called Jack's office. He wasn't in. But I talked to his assistant, and we got him committed to be a keynote speaker at an event we were doing on one of the campuses. We had a lot of students coming in, and we needed a keynote speaker. So that day I was standing at the curb in the parking lot waiting on this very prestigious executive, the vice chairman and CFO of a very prestigious company, Walmart. I was pretty nervous. I wasn't real sure if I could handle myself well in front of this person. Looked down the driveway, and up the driveway came a pickup truck. I grew up on a farm, so I knew what a pickup truck was. So I was a little bit more at ease. And as that pickup pulled up to the curb and the door opened, I saw a cowboy boot hit the pavement. I looked down at my own cowboy boots I wore at the time and said, you know what, I think I can do business with this guy. He got out of the truck, stuck out his hand, said, hi, I'm Jack Shoemaker. And he said, by the way, did you know I grew up in the county next here, and my family still lives there. So I was instantly at ease. We hit it off. We walked into the auditorium. He delivered the most incredible speech I have ever heard in my life to that point.
I have had so much fun in talking to these young people on the campuses and listening to their thoughts about the future. They are the future. And, you know, maybe all I do actually is listen to what they ask and share a bit of my experience with them, tell them that I've been through hard times too, and that you can't let that discourage you, and that there is a lot to be said about sharing what you know with others.
On the walk back to the truck, he said, you know, Sam and I have talked, and we think we want to really get involved with SIFE. So what can we do? We're ready to write a check, but is there more that we can do to help? I told him that what we really needed was leadership. I asked him if he would consider serving as chairman of the board and really helping us become a national organization and really give us the credibility of himself and Walmart to really help us introduce ourselves to more universities and colleges and more business leaders. He said, Sam and I have been talking about SIFE. We really like what you do. We like what the students do. We like them as potential talent. So on the spot, he agreed to be the chairman of the board. It made a huge difference. At the board meetings, as I shared, the first question we usually asked was, can we make it to the next quarter, or should we throw in the towel? Jack Shoemaker took over as chairman, looked at everybody in the room and said, my first question is, how high is up? It changed the whole attitude of everybody in the room. And we went up. His first year as chairman, we went from 22 to 65 universities. And SIFE grew and grew under his leadership, both as our chairman and as a long-term member of our board. As our chairman, one of the things he did, which was extremely helpful, is everywhere he traveled for Walmart business, he would squeeze in a breakfast, a lunch, a reception, a dinner, some event to tell business leaders about SIFE. One of the things I noticed as we were doing those events all across the country is that before we were finished with the event, Jack made sure that he had met everybody in the room. And by everybody, I meant not just those who were invited guests, the important people, but everybody in the room. He met every server. He met every person that was there to clean up the glasses. Whatever their job was, if they were in the room, he would go up and introduce himself. Hi, I'm Jack Shoemaker. And he would read their name badge and talk to them in first person, first name. How are you? Where are you from? He really made everyone in that room feel important. When I met with him in his office, at one point I saw on his wall, he had a sign that said, if you treat people as they are, that's who they will be. But if you treat people as if they are who they can become, that's who they'll become. And I realized that's what he was doing with everybody in those rooms, was he was really helping each one of them understand their own worth and thanking them for who they were and what they did to contribute to the success of that event. After I read that sign, I also realized that's what he was doing with me, because it wasn't really that smart of a thing for a person of his stature to work with a young guy right out of law school with this floundering organization. But he saw in SIFE and he saw in me a much bigger future and a much bigger opportunity. And he treated us as if we are what we could become, not just what we were then or who I was then.
When I discovered that I could become more successful simply by making my goal to make others successful, that's SIFE.
One of the most critical decisions we had to make as an organization several years ago was whether or not we would be a U.S.-only organization or whether we would really go international. We had a lot of colleges and universities and business leaders from outside the U.S. who saw SIFE and what we were doing in the U.S. and wanted that opportunity in their country. And some of them had even tried to start SIFE teams and come to the U.S. to compete. As an organization, we had to make a decision, and our board just kept bouncing back and forth from meeting to meeting as to whether we should go international or just stay an American organization. Finally, at one of those meetings, which was actually held in Walmart's corporate office in their auditorium, Jack stood up and he said, "I want you to understand how I stand on this position." He said, "I grew up in Dallas County, Missouri." He said, "Some of my classmates who were my best friends lived in houses with dirt floors." He said, "We were a poor county." He said, "Fortunately, I had a good family. I got a good education. And I lived in a country that gave me the opportunity to reach my full potential." He said, "I want young people around the world to have that same opportunity." He said, "I've now traveled the world, and everywhere I go, I talk to young people. And I realize that they're as smart as I was, they're as hardworking as I was, but a lot of them are in places where they don't have the opportunity that we have in this country, and I want to find a way to share that with them." So he said, "I'm going to find a way to do that. I had hoped that SIFE would be the organization to help me do that. But if not, I'll find another place to invest my time and money, and we're going to bring this free enterprise and business to the rest of the world." Immediately, we held a vote. We got a unanimous decision, and the charter was changed, that SIFE would now be an international organization. Without Jack Shoemaker stepping up that day and saying what he really believed and putting his reputation on the line, SIFE never would have gone international. And without him, it would have taken years and probably never would have happened.
Just remember this. You've already won. You're already in our hearts forever. And you can contribute to the success of the world by coming together in a way that us older people haven't been able to do. Accept the challenge. Do what you can. And care about others. God bless you all. Thank you.
Jack shared with me in my last phone call with him. In his last conversation with Sam Walton, that Jack knew was going to be his last conversation with Sam Walton. One of the things Sam said was, "Jack, let's keep this SIFE thing going. It's good for America, and it's good for the world." Well, in that conversation I had with Jack just a week before he passed away, neither one of us had a clue it was going to be our last conversation. But he said, "Alvin, this SIFE thing, let's keep it going. It's even more important for America and more important for the world than it's ever been." So as I think about Jack and all that I learned from him, I think the question we all need to ask ourselves about SIFE and about ourselves, how high is up? So Jack, we're going to keep this SIFE thing going. And we're always going to ask the question, how high is up?
We're still a young organization. But I have to believe that somewhere, one of those students is going to make a huge difference in the world. I would like to be there, yeah, but probably won't. But the fact of the matter is it's a pretty good feeling thinking that you might have helped them along the way to better understand what happens and to change the world.